Memorization. Memorization, not planning. So some might even find it a little boring. So this person is not even teaching. You came to teach, but you are now questioning us. So what have you taught? So they think that you have to you have to give the notes. And when we enter the class, I know that it happens every semester. The students are asking, will you give us notes? Some of us are even asking, will you also give us this this assignment? But if students are used to creating learning by themselves, they will not even think about your slides or notes. They know that they are going to discover on their own. I think this is what we, it is: ability to present, evaluate, interpret data, develop lines of arguments, and make sound judgment. It has helped students to ask questions and look for answers. You know, public policy, not public administration, the year tools. And they are online students. And when I entered into the class, I felt, how will I manage? The second week, how will I manage? So I got a solution. The solution was that I found that students of social work, social administration also have the same class that they put in another year. I went and confused the administrator. So we brought the class together. We brought the class together. So those who were talking, when the group became bigger with the social work, because now we became 29, 26, 29, we're not there. When the class became bigger, we were using this room, and we used to be straight and out. So I found that those students were not even talking. At the end, they were the loudest. They were the loudest. So it helps the students start asking questions and look for answers, to apply what they have learned, to solve problems, to listen to each other, and also to better ideas. You are most welcome. Do you have a Zoom app on your machine? You know, for us, we started using technology to study, to learn. You can share with somebody for the time being.
To maximize our
potential. Maximize our fortunes. Listen to each other and bet on ideas. So I think these are things that we have been talking about. The assumption is that it facilitates active learning. It facilitates critical thinking. It helps students that they should make aware of the thinking process. They should not only come to be spectators and entertained by that professor who talks strong words, strong terminologies, but they are part of the thinking. Critical thinking should be must be taught explicitly, that is, we need to really go to it. I think here at the university, there are only two groups that are taught critical thinking, explicitly as a course. So it needs to be perhaps made a bit wider and more content as well. And here is a very powerful statement that teachers often confuse physical attention for mental attention. You can see everybody looking at you and see that everything is okay. So we don't need to confuse the physical attention with the mental attention. And case teaching, so the active teaching will help to reduce the physical attention, but increase what we call the mental attention, because students will get more involved into that work. These are like terminologies for the class is out, so it is soon getting out. We have a few minutes. But it's okay because afterwards we have to get a case. Active learning students involve in doing things and think about the things they are doing. Critical thinking reasonable reflective thinking that is focused on deciding what to do and what to believe, or interpreting, analyzing, or evaluating information, judgments, and experiences with a set of reflective attitudes, skills, abilities to guide all our thoughts, beliefs, and actions, or examining the thinking of others to improve their own. So critical thinking is very broad because it really helps students to evaluate, students to critically look at issues, to decide, and develop that talent of being an active member, not only of the class, but the member of society. And when these students get out, we are talking about employability, these students will have that ability to think other alternatives, out of the box, to think alternatives that can bring him a job or a job that can make him work very well on the job and other things. So, and that's what we are leading to. So how do we help this? Remember the other lady who gave us a talk on the other Friday, when she ran the first presentation, she said that only 3% of the Ghanaians are employers. 3%. And we are employing, I don't know how many. How do we increase the 3% to 20%? I'm sure that if we increase the 3% to 20%, we shall absorb much of Ghana's problems. Or we increase it up to 50%, then we shall be importing laborers the way we are sending our ladies to those places. So we shall be bringing now more ladies here and sending them out. I know. So this is what I'm talking about, that Cliff and Wright, in their work of 1996, reported that students in anatomy, those were students who were doing medicine, they said that using the case made them easier to learn by 74%, depending on the understanding, 7%. Attendance in general biological course based on term, team learning, and test study was 95%, 100%, compared to 65, up to 86 to 85, in various courses based on lecture. So meaning that if we bring the cases, students will get stimulated, we'll think that we missed the class, have missed a lot, we missed the voice of this other student and the others, and the discussion that has coming out, and we increase the attendance of the students in the class. Let's go to the case. I have my case up here so that we can. The class is ending on Zoom.
The case explains to society that accepts the legal.
We are looking at the hand, it accepts
legal marriage. But people are not having
that. So it is a society that only accepts legal marriage. And what is legal marriage?
Marriage has been blessed by the church.
By the priest. So it recognizes a marriage which is only recognized and blessed by a priest. Another one.
That this scenario expresses challenges in the situations, marriage situations.
Mm-hmm.
For example, much as the priest had to go to the plantation once a year,
yes.
2 years elapsed without coming. And then, the situation of the people, the way they live, it means
they must continue living.
They must continue. Yeah, they should not go for the
priest. Maybe the priest has a very big parish land, and he has a big plantation, and there are people working in the plantation, life has to continue, the priest has not come, they cannot wait for the priest to have more marriages.
Meaning that he...
I can see a practical case of shortage of priests in that society.
Mm-hmm.
If the priest would take like a whole 1 year to go, even if it was more every year, for this large plantation, and all these groups of people, they would need to spend like 2 weeks officiating on this. So not the weddings, the marriages.
Yeah.
So there was shortage of priests in that area, so pastors face the problem. How do you collect weddings when the priests are not available? Yes.
I also see a society where people don't abide by the law. Yes, can you tell us more? Yes, because in that society, people are supposed to stay together when they are married officially. But these ones,
but they are supposed to told us that 2 years the peace has all come. So at least our power problem, the years are changing them.
They are plantation workers.
They are plantation workers.
But that one should not stop them for the life.
Yes.
There could be also a case of either those people within the plantation, they do not have sufficient education for them to be trained as priests, so that the number is bigger for the plantation, or the people themselves are lost in the plantation, they don't want to become priests.
Yeah. I do believe that Latin America is largely Catholic. Mm-hmm. Latin America is largely Catholic. And being largely Catholic, you know how it takes to become a Catholic priest. Mm-hmm. You need from over 8 years. So how would they find a worker who is working in the plantation, they make the corporation of the plantation, the little education, how do you expect them to become priests in 8 years so that they come as well? Yes.
I think also they need some other bylaws apart from this. So, because many things are happening.
You are not assuming?
Yes. Actually, I feel that wherever there is a law, there should be other conditions which should be considered.
Like what?
For example, like the decision of the farm manager to grant these people a house for the couples.
Okay.
That farm manager was really understanding.
So let's think that there's not by law. Let's say think that there's not by law.
If it was not there.
And the case before us is that there's no by law. Yes.
In the society, we see that the farm manager just acts without proper evidence. If he had asked those people to prove whether they are married or not, we wouldn't have had these other problems.
The
person
is not there. They have come to you.
The farm manager is
But yet, we are not yet to do what he should be doing. We are looking at the case.
Yes.
We are looking at what is happening, what is there, what is the situation, what is the context. What is the context? Before we go into what we have done, what is the context?
In this society, people live ordinary lifestyles. They go after your plantation staff, you have to socialize.
How were they housed in the farm? How were they organized? How was the housing situation within the farm?
It is a single cell contain. Then for bachelors, it is a kind of
two.
It's a dormitory. It's where they are not having the private.
Can we put the names into this? What are the people that are named in the case?
There is
Joyce. What are the people that are
named?
Joyce. Who is Joyce?
The young lady.
Who is Joyce? The young lady?
Yes.
Who is that?
Galgalo.
Galgalo.
Wife.
Or whose authority?
I mean, me as the farm manager, I think the authority.
The priest will listen to me when they make some wrong decisions. Because they came to me, and the priest has spent 3 years, remember? The priest has stayed away for them 3 years. And people are doing their business. People are growing older. These 3 years, the priest could have had a wedding of about 200 or so, whichever they have. But the priest had also made a mistake. 3 years, we are nowhere here. And yet, I have people who are growing. Age is catching up with them every other year. So as a manager, I have stood on behalf of the priest to accept the ban. But I'm waiting for the priest to come and officiate. I wait 1 year, he has not come. 2 more years, he has not come. So both of us are on the wrong. If the priest was not to come, You would find a way that you'd have been a catechist somewhere.
Three of you went the wrong.
Disagree.
Okay,
the coming of the priest has nothing to do with your staying together. You understand? The priest has not come. You are supposed to stay single until the priest comes. So it is also a mistake when the priest is not coming. Let us stay together.
If the priest takes care of that, he hasn't come.
Yes, you wait. Because you've been doing something illegal.
You went to my side.
But Ed is catching up with me.
But it is wrong.
You wait until the Lord comes back.
But you want to go against the law? Because Ed is catching up with you. Now do you see the problems we are causing?
You see the problems that even to the manager who was finishing pathetic.
Yes.
So we are causing a problem even to the person who was finishing pathetic to you.
Very humanitarian.
And fellow workers, perhaps it was not that they were had been given a house. That way there could be some other 3 or 5 people who are also causing them a problem.
By the example. Your fellow workers.
So let us stop there.
Just from there.
Let us now discuss what we have been doing. Let us now discuss what we have been doing. What is an advantage from our own discussion on this case? What is the disadvantage that we find we have gained in the class when we are teaching this case to the students? From what we have discussed from among ourselves,
what is it?
What are the positive things, positive things that you discover that you have involved in as a class now?
Yes, there's free expression and communication.
Free expression and communication?
Yeah, there is also detailed analysis of the general topic of discussion.
Detailed analysis? Students would have reflected on real life issues, life issues, and also maybe later they would act responsibly. Because now, that thing touches everyone. Consider that you can do something. You might think you are doing something right, but it can even...
It seems that special can come up later on in life.
Yes, in life, and you know that.
Yes, you don't compromise.
So still, you look at a case from two or more shades of lifestyle. Yes. Because you look at, if I take this decision, these are the repercussions. If it is that,
these are the consequences.
So, critiquing continues.
So there is a lot of critiquing, a lot of thinking that is involved. The students are now involved into thinking. So you are leading them into thinking about life, about situation, about work, about other things that are involved in management. So rather than if I came to class and they say, when you have a problem like this, you solve it like this. You write down the things. You go out to the class. But if we involve them into a case, they look at it, they debate it, they get involved into solving the case, they go out with the dilemma, because we say, oh, cases are open-ended. We cannot get the real answer, it's open-ended. So you have, because social life is also open-ended, it has many ways of solving it. So the student will go out when they know that they have discussed this and it continues at the back of their mind, how would I fall into this? Later on, perhaps in life, when they are at work, and they go into the problem, they live up at the other case that Matovu taught them, or this is not taught, but facilitated to them, and then they say, how do I enter into this? There's a lot of things that involved into this kind of study. Another one? Yes.
It helps to discover the underlying assumptions the learners have about the issue.
Yes.
So if you aim, for example, at discovering and challenging the way they are thinking about, some people think life is black and white, and there are no gray areas, and you're trying to break certain assumptions through listening to the discussion. So for example, Peter's stance, it is against the law, but you're not paying attention to the social aspects of what is happening at a farm like that. The priest is not there, yes, the law exists, but there's also a human side to what happens. How many farm workers needed, what would happen to the morale of the workers if you denied them, you know, getting into relationships? all those things are the things that the farm manager has to work with. What with the morale? If they are going to be escaping from the farm to meet their girlfriends outside, how would it affect the work? Because for you, they are measuring you against the outcomes.
Yeah.
So sometimes the cases help us to discover those assumptions and then we begin to tease them out.
Tease these assumptions out.
Yeah.
And there are many things that we get. I mean, if the class was about double this one, and different ideas that come from the other person, you would even get far back to reach a discussion that will come up. And then better to come out that have been rich. And then you find that you, the students have gotten involved into helping themselves to learn and see how they solve the problems. So the person who has learned through this type of study, put him aside with someone who has been learning from a productive way, where a teacher who was teaching management told them the answer, which is closed, another which is closed, another which is closed, and find them on the top like this one. This one who has done like this one will have a critical thinking, will have more way of juggling out with ideas than the other one over there. The type of method, right?
Yeah, that is true. But it requires, I think, ample time to prepare these scenarios, especially the scenarios which have covered a number of topics. Because there is a need to cover a number of topics in a particular scenario, and that requires really enough time.
There are different topics that you never thought you would come into the class that have come inside here.
True.
There's a lot that you have covered which you never thought about.
That is true.
And perhaps each student would have got his or her own, and another would get something else. And if they are very serious students, they go out and start searching. They start searching, you create into them that zeal to go and search for knowledge rather than waiting for the teacher to come and help them to get the knowledge. So if the debate is so strong and so good, it never ends here. They go with it outside. In groups, in 2, 3, 4, 5. So they go down, they get out, they can even spend the whole semester when they think about it. And
others are even named.
They can get the name.
That situation, you can also think about the morale as well in the community. But now when you look at the repercussions and the morale, don't you want to say, you know, let them be demotivated, but
the farm manager is after realizing the profits.
Yes.
Meeting and the objectives of the farm.
Their job.
So these are just the conditions which affect his work.
I were assuming that the farm workers are only males.
In this particular plantation.
Where is it stated? That these ladies are not farm workers. That those girls are
those tell us that these are farm workers. One was got from the market.
No, they only said about one person. So where is the statement that in that farm there are no women?
Okay. Because of the word of bachelors. Did you get the term?
Bachelors.
Yeah. Bachelors is a very old thing.
Yes. Yeah. They used to house bachelors. That was supposed to give you
spista.
Yeah.
If they say bachelors means there was a role for bachelors and a role for the families.
Yes.
So it means that there could have been some women, either working or not working, but in the farm as well.
Mm.
So the farm was housing
bachelors.
All sexes.
Yeah.
No, but women were not
right farm workers.
No, the women were not the
farm workers.
Yes.
So this is not a good farm. This plantation does not exist in the world. Because I don't see a plantation like this one anywhere in the world. Why are they not going to be together with the men?
No, they actually went to visit this plantation. It's a real case. It's not fictitious.
So there is no
male workers. And that is how when
so
you're teaching out to
tell that somebody's not a village setting.
A lot of torture in the farm.
This is a dangerous farm.
I think in that farm there is a lot of moonlighting.
So let us also listen to those are the positive things that we discover. Do we discover some negative
aspects into our discussion.
I think the only negative one is that we can keep discussing until Jesus comes back.
I think the system ends.
So the one is because this one can never end.
Would you get students who are like this in the class with
what? Except those who think they cannot speak. Which
no, they must be able to speak because they must be able to speak. They have to think. You cannot get people who are graded like this.
Mm.
So and everybody is reflecting, is participating, and the result is seriously positive.
But you also have to be an expert if you are to guide.
Yes. And, so you see those questions you were giving. Yes.
Yeah.
But that information is not there. It's not provided. Those kind of things. Mm-hmm. They have the discussion to move.
Mm-hmm. So you have to prepare for the case.
Mm. I think apart from not having a final answer to this, there is need to have skills. Call them group, working with the groups of skills of working with the groups. Because if you don't have those, you might not manage to get something out of it.
Mm-hmm.
It is so complex, eh?
Yeah.
So complex.
Mm-hmm.
But another thing, don't you, as the facilitator, don't you need to have like an end that this thing is supposed to lead into this, or we just leave it open?
Mm-hmm. Of course, I guess it's always friendly into the lecture, into what you are looking at.
The theme of the...
Yeah, this is an open case for anything, eh?
Mm.
But you have to get the case that fit into what you are like. And this can be used in many, many, many instances.
Maybe he's asking if there is some kind of conclusion after
conclusion from this. You.
Yeah.
We shall see later
what
on.
Is,
yeah. We shall see later on when I in the cases, that the cases also have teacher's notes.
As a guiding you.
Yes, it has
guiding
you. It has teacher's notes.
Mm-hmm.
And the teacher's notes will give you not the conclusive thing, but how you can conclude the case. Okay. I have already shown you a case for me. I asked you what have you learned. Because for me, my conclusion was what will the students see, any positive or negative things. So, but every case will have teacher's notes.
Okay.
Okay.
Also, one thing is there was so much hidden information from this particular case, and so which is okay. It is you to learn the art of when you introduce another piece of information to them to keep the debate going. So you can collect as much information as you want, but pick that which will trigger the discussion.
You put in the what if.
Yes.
I have sent you a message. Please, can you go back and enter into the lecture? The lecture is now not limited to the walls where you are, but it goes with the student. So, and submit case study answer prior to class. You submit the case study answers. If they say the case, maybe some answers, you can do that. I had a case, but I don't want to go through it. Analysis of the case, analysis case study, the one that we're doing. This analysis study focuses development of analytical skills, understanding of practical problem. You can see that we try to understand what is the law. People will now discuss about law. Another one was discussing the psychology. They had some psychology issues here. So, so there are a lot of things that you have grappled with within that small case. Half a page. But what we have learned is more than 10 pages. Mm? So one structure of analysis study, you can use a journal article, you can provide international table of figures, you can analyze a table of figures, that's discussion with student analysis, you can provide a case which is not here, and other things. The dilemma case study promotes the development of higher order reasoning skills, understanding. I remember when we were studying logic in the philosophy, how to go through the holes of a dilemma. So we're studying what we call the syllogisms. Syllogisms, and the higher you go into symbolic logic, the higher you go into serious dilemmas. How do you get out of those dilemmas?
So.
My name is.
So what we're doing, we're creating serious dilemmas to the manager.